I'm left alone. I've always been an eagle, been a while since I have flown.
Make the world go away.
Hank Cochran is without a doubt one of the greatest songwriters ever on earth.
And I fall to pieces.
It's important historically that people know who Hank Cochran was and what he did, and he always wanted to be the Hemingway of country music, and I think he did it.
This ain't my first rodeo.
It's stunning. You look at the body of work that he was able to accomplish and stay relevant for so long. That's way out of the ordinary.
I've got everything but you.
Hank had hits for over 40 years, and will probably have, these songs will pop up, you know, 50, 100 years from now. They'll be recording Hank Cochran songs way down the line and probably not even know who he was.
I came to town a long time ago, and it's really been good to me, as you all know.
I think it's really important for people to understand where country music came from and the era of the 50s and 60s, which is Hank Cochran, Harlan Howard, Willie Nelson, Roger Miller. These guys set the standard for writing songs.
I don't do windows, and I don't come to work till 9. And if you make me mad, I won't come to work anytime.
He was responsible really for me going to Nashville and getting a job writing for Pamper Music. Hank had a lot to do with me getting started.
Won't you ever get tired of hurting me?
Somebody must have hurt you long ago. But why take revenge?
I met Hank through Buddy and Dale Dodson. He reached out his hand and had a CD that already had my name on it. So kind of gathered that this wasn't by chance.
Shortly after you first met him, Hank was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. So for the 2 years he lived after that, Jamie would get off the road and pull his bus right up to the hospital, run up, see Hank, raise Hank's spirits, and just, he was always, always around. Up to the night Hank died, he was here.
Now tell me, would these arms be in your way?
It was shortly after Hank died, I got a text message, and it was from Jamie, and he said, would you mind if I did a Hank Cochran album? I couldn't believe it, you know.
Would you mind another heart?
Well, Hank's passing was what kind of kicked off the idea. When we all met at the house one day, sang some songs, Bobby Bear was introducing me to a bunch of songs. When I thought I'd heard it all, I hadn't heard anything yet. All the best stuff was the stuff I didn't know about yet. I can't even say that anything beyond just, hey, let's do a Hank record was my idea, because it was just something that was breathed into the air by everybody.
And then I didn't hear from him for a long time. And then the next thing I knew, I saw him someplace and he came running up and said, I'm doing it, you know, I'm doing it.
But if you're gonna play the jukebox, please.
We were talking about who to call. People just kind of presented themselves. I think the word got out after a while, and Buddy was getting phone calls about people wanting to do it. So there wasn't a whole lot of arms that needed twisting.
Everybody got to pick their own. And so for me, it was just as much a journey as it was for the band or anybody else involved.
And she always played A11.
A11's a wonderful song. one of the all-time, I guess you'd call it, standard.
It's from an era when country music was pretty much confined to beer joints and clubs. I mean, for Hank to be able to write stuff that goes from the gamut to, I Fall to Pieces, to Make the World Go Away, to a song like A11, which is pretty primal, straightforward, I call it beer joint music, it's pretty cool.
Make the world go away.
When they were talking about the duet album, I kept saying Hank's favorite singer was Alison Krauss. He always used to listen to Alison Krauss albums. Every new CD that came out, Hank had. You need to get Alison Krauss. And Hank had never met Alison Krauss. And then I heard that she was on the album, and I heard she was doing Make the World Go Away. I was thrilled to death.
Say the things you used to say.
You know, he was really an artist who chose not to be an artist. All the artists respected his ability to perform a song. The singers wanted to see if they could just sing that good. And singers that understood wanted to sing his songs right. I know I did.
Well, he was pretty much foundation as a songwriter for a long time. He covered a lot of ground.
When it comes to his place in country music, he'll go down with Hank Williams, Floyd Tillman, Fred Rose, Cindy Walker, all of those great writers.
Songwriter puts the spirit in it. Once it has that, it doesn't care what whose voice adds to it. It simply adds to it.
He should be in the Country Music Hall of Fame. I know he's in the Songwriters Hall of Fame for sure, but Hank Cochran, he was very influential in setting the bar for all the writers that we have coming down the line.
If I had to dream up somebody like Hank to influence songwriters, I couldn't have done a better job. That's what he was, not just for me, but for Willie and for a lot of people, was just a helpful friend. If he knew you needed help with something, and he could help you, he was there. And that's what I want to be for the people in my life, the same as Hank, you know. So he influenced you not only as an artist and songwriter, but also just as a person.